everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is Mimi, and as you know, this channel is all about modern motherhood. I post videos about family, about entrepreneurship, and about fashion. So please follow if those things are things that you're interested in. I taught undergraduate education for almost a decade at some of the top universities here in Southern California. But prior to academia, I was a professional athlete. I was a soccer player, and I represented Ghana in the Women's World Cup. Ghana is a country in West Africa, not to be confused with Guyana. Now I have two children, a 10-year-old girl and a 7-year-old boy. Actually, my daughter is turning 11 next week. And I am both their personal trainer and soccer coach. You can check out a recent video that I did on the art of coaching your own child. If you're a parent that's a coach, or you're just a parent who's supporting a competitive child athlete, I recommend that you check it out. So I thought it would be a really fun follow-up to my video about coaching your own child to just vlog our entire State Cup experience. So this might be a multi-part series, but my plan is to just start from this week through the end of the tournament. So my daughter is with the AYSO United Soccer Club. It's kind of interesting because we started in AYSO, we went into the AYSO Extra program, and then we understood that AYSO was developing a club program. And even though it was a new program, I thought it would be a great additional intermediate step to a more competitive club environment. But it has been fantastic. The girls have been fantastic. My co-coach has been great. The training is excellent. So we're really happy where we are. So last year was our first year with the club. We had a great season. We hardly lost any games last year. We went to the State Cup soccer tournament and we actually won. So out of 164 teams from the CALSOUTH division, we came out as number one. We got bumped up a bracket and we went undefeated all season. We were eliminated in the League Cup tournament this year in penalty kicks, but now we're looking ahead to our State Cup tournament, which starts this weekend. So of course a tournament like the State Cup tournament is a challenge, but we're facing an additional challenge because several of our players are injured or are just coming back from injury. It's wild, we're just gonna have to make the best of it. But I just wanted to share an email that I sent out to the team earlier this week to just offer them some encouragement. Team United, this has been a challenging week in sports. Within our team, we've learned three players will definitely not be able to play with us for our State Cup tournament due to injury, two of which are our goalkeepers. At the same time, the entire world is grappling with the shocking loss of one of the greatest athletes of our time, Kobe Bryant. I want to clearly communicate that I still believe that this team is the best in the state for our age group and division, and I still intend to lead this team to victory with Coach Atar. For inspiration, we should consider two quotes by the late Kobe Bryant, who was a professional champion. First, everything negative, pressure, challenges, is all an opportunity for me to rise. Kobe Bryant. The injuries we have are a negative challenge, but we've already proved earlier in this season that we can rise from this. With focus, confidence, and perseverance, we can and will overcome this challenge again. Everyone who's healthy should be careful and responsible next week. Please continue making the effort to maximize your stamina. This is more important than ever. The second quote is, I'll do whatever it takes to win games, whether it's sitting on a bench waving a towel, handing a cup of water to a teammate, or hitting the game-winning shot. Kobe Bryant. I want to emphasize that this is a championship team because of the humble hearts of the players who've demonstrated a willingness to play different positions, to play past exhaustion, to do whatever it takes. In the spirit of this quote, even our injured players and our parents supporting us on the sidelines have a role to play in getting us over the State Cup finish line. Everyone has a meaningful role in this team, and I'm calling on each one of you to commit to doing more, whatever you can, to help this team win what we've earned over the past season. Be prepared to play anywhere with your most determined effort. Be prepared to pass water to tired players. Be prepared with an encouraging word. We're going to march on, Team United, and I'm looking forward to great training sessions this week. Best, Coach. coach me. So we did have two great training sessions this week. My co-coach, Coach Atar, was away. He actually has been invited to train for his UEFA license. So he was in Ireland all week. So I had to hold down practices by myself this week, but he will be back in time for the games, which will be played in Temecula. So the energy was great around practice this week. I feel like the girls are excited, a little bit nervous, and I told them a little bit of nerves is excellent because it means that this really matters to you. So I talked to them a little bit about diet and nutrition and attitude and focus, and gave them the idea that maybe they could watch some of the women's Olympic qualifying games on the way down in the morning on Saturday morning. Typically, I like to get down the night before if we have early games, but this Friday night is the mother-son dance and I can't miss that. So Link and I will be going to the dance. And then after the dance in the morning, we'll get up early and head down to this tournament, and then we'll stay overnight. We'll come back on Sunday. All right, good morning, good morning. We are officially starting our State Cup journey. It is almost 7 a.m. We're just hitting the road on our way down to Temecula. Say good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Good morning. All right, so just to add to a little bit of the drama, we have brought our dog Scotch. And this is going to be one of his first trips with us, road trips. But hopefully, we're trying to train ourselves to also travel with him on road trips. So, going to add a little bit more fun into the mix. And yeah, we will check in shortly. Last night, Lincoln and I went to the parent-child dance. I was calling it mommy-son dance because he and I went. We had a really good time, but what's wild is in between the parent-child dance and the soccer game this morning, we've been asked to potentially host a fundraising party for a 2020 presidential candidate. So that's kind of also in my mind right now as we're heading to this game, thinking about the logistics of that. It's kind of a short time frame. But my co-coach is back from Ireland. He finished his first round of his UEFA training, and he's going to make it to the afternoon game. He won't be there for the morning, so just got to continue to hold it down for the team. The sun is finally out. I'm definitely a bit sleepy, but I'm going to drink this yerba mate here in a minute, and hopefully that'll give me the kick in the pants that I need. Don't try to act like you don't want to dance. Make sure that you do your first thing correctly before you set the tone. Understand what I'm saying?
finish, ladies. Game.
All right, so we are back at the field for the second game. We took the first game 3-0, convincing victory. Could have been a lot more, but hopefully we just are saving up our shots and our goals for when it really counts. Let's hope that's what it is. So fortunately our goalie was able to play. One of our goalies was able to come back and play half of the game. So hopefully we'll be able to use her again. Laya had a great game. The girls are really gelling and coming together.
What'd you tell them at halftime? What'd you tell them?
Well, I think the thing that probably stood out to everybody is I was saying there's a time and a place to be a mean girl. And when you're on the field in front of the goal, that's the time, that's the place, and I wanted to see it. So hopefully we're bringing a little bit more of that competitive, that's right, Lincoln, that competitive mindset to this game and our game tomorrow.
Another one down. Good job, ladies.
After the two victories on Saturday, we had some team bonding time at a local tavern that had axe throwing and then at a pet shop. Closing the door, he's like, that's it. The next morning when we got up, it was one of those cold, rainy mornings where you just want to stay in bed all day, but not all of us got to. It was really pouring and coming down, but when the rainbow came out, I knew we were going to be okay. Okay, so as Kofi just said,
boom, we came, we saw, we conquered. 3-0.
Laya, where you at? Shout out to Laya. She had a great three games.
Amazing. Great job, coach.
Thank you. First weekend of State Cup is down under our belts. We are moving forward. We are out of pool play. Because we won today, we are going to be well seeded and play the number two team from the other bracket. So we're just moving forward. And even though we had bad weather today, it is raining, it is pouring, we still conquered and defeated. So excellent.